I would like to tell you a little story. It's a Second World War story that really happened about 12 years ago. Now, since about always I'm interested in the history of the Second World War, which can easily be explained, I suppose, by the fact that we live here in history. Here in the region several battles have took place, and the little town where I used to live is been destroyed for 95% by Allied bombing. The pictures you see here comes from a book I have for several years, and in there is the story of the civilians. Now, I always have been more interested in the civilian, in the personal story of the Second World War, not these big battles and D-Day. Oh, by the way, talking of D-Day, everyone knows D-Day and all these heroic actions, but the bombardments before and after D-Day took 50,000 civilian lives, according to some historians. 50,000. But I suppose that's just a statistic. Now, my children, they have seen these pictures, they know this book, they know that there is a German tank in the middle of the town where we live. They've seen all these displays spread over town. They know a bit the history. So sometimes we went to visit some museum or battlefields and all other kind of stuff. But don't worry, we also went to the zoo and the swimming pool, of course, like every normal family. And one day we decided to visit this fort. So first we visited the inside of the fort, and of course I forgot to take my photo camera out of the car, so I don't have pictures from the inside of the fort, but whatever. And I explained a bit how it works, and we went through these 2 kilometers of tunnels everywhere. It's really interesting. And then of course I explained a bit at child niveau, eh? And after went back to the car, take my photo camera, and we visited the outside of the fort. We went to the roof. This one goes no further. Now, here's a picture of one of the domes. This one is a 75 millimeter double cannon with a reach of 10 kilometers. Yeah, that's correct. 75 millimeter, 10 kilometer reach. And it's getting inspected by my 2 little pirates. Of course, this is 12 years ago. In the meanwhile, they changed a little bit. Now they are big pirates. And that's where I spotted these 2 men coming our way. Of course, they didn't came for us, they came for this cannon dome. I didn't pay too much attention, because it's absolutely normal that people come visit. After all, this fort is open to the public. And as these 2 men came closer, I saw that one of them was about my age and the other one was at least 20 years older. Let's call them the young man and the old man. And in the meanwhile, of course, as I suppose all normal children, my two pirates had to climb on top of this dome. And just for fun, I say, "Oh, be careful not to break it." And the younger man thought that was funny and he started to laugh with it. And that's how we started to talk to each other. And he told me that they were from Germany. In fact, it was father and son. And the son, the young man, he was driving his father around to visit all the forts and other World War II things that we can find here in the region. Now, the conversation with these two men was not really easy because they spoke German. I understand a little bit German, but I don't speak German. And the younger man, he spoke English. So I spoke English with the younger man. And then I translated in French to explain to my kids. But they were far too busy playing around with this dome. The older man, he didn't talk much. You could see that he was completely plunged in his memory. He was completely dreamed away. And the younger man told me, in fact, that his father, he was in the German army. During the Second World War, the older man, he was a pilot in the Luftwaffe. Now, for me, this was a wonderful occasion because I always talk to witnesses from bombardments and other war stories, but that live here in the region. And now I had a conversation with someone from, let's say, the other side, from the German side. Now, having the chance to talk to a German war veteran is rather unique, of course. So I decided to try to squeeze the whole story out of this man. And I talked to the older man. It was a bit complicated in German, but we started to figure it out. And he told me that as a young boy, he was in the Hitlerjugend. Of course, these boys, all boys, went to the Hitlerjugend because they had no choice. And that's what he told us too. They had no choice. Everybody had to go to the Hitlerjugend, where they, of course, they were indoctrinated and brainwashed. That's not what he told us, but you could see in his eyes, in his memory, that was not really a funny period. After the Hitlerjugend, he went to the army. And there, of course, too, they had no choice. Every German boy had to go to the army. He told me that his time in the Luftwaffe, he didn't fly much because there was not enough fuel for the airplanes. And from the few flights he did, in fact, he didn't talk much about it. I tried to know where he was flying, but he didn't tell me. But you can see on his face that it doesn't have to be too beautiful. And that's about where the conversation stopped, because he was completely plunged in his memory. And I saw his eyes started to swell up. And that's how they say, I think. This man had a really difficult moment. And then followed a moment of difficult silence. And then the younger man said to me, "You know what, give me your photo camera and go sit with your kids near this Canon dome and I will take a picture of the three of you." And here's this picture this man took. Now, it's me and my two kids 12 years ago, but that's not that important. What I think is important in this picture is the shadows you see. You can see the shadow, the right one, is the man who took the picture, and the left shadow is the old man that had a really difficult time at this moment. I suppose you can understand I didn't took any pictures of these two men because the old man had really a difficult time and I think it's not appropriate to take photos from someone who is not good in his head at that moment. And then after this photo was taken, of course this young man gave me back my photo camera, not a problem. And I wanted to continue talk to this older man. And the first thing he said to me was, "I'm sorry for all these nasty things I did." And I took one step forward and I reach him my hand. And he takes my hand and puts his left hand on top of both of our hands. And he started to cry.